My mother was the most bubbly sort of person. She loved to eat, she loved to cook, although she could only really cook about 5 dishes really, really well. Back then it was all about being out with the family, out for dinner. It's all about that enjoyment of food, and I think that's really why when she lost her sense of taste, it became a real big part of the sort of her downfall, I guess. Hi, I'm Brian Riley, and this is why I started a cancer cookery school. I was 18 years old when my mother was diagnosed with small cell lung cancer. I was my mother's primary carer, and I was the one that saw her go through her treatment, but also saw her trying to live her life as well. And it was a very difficult and emotional time. When you have cancer treatment, either chemotherapy or radiotherapy, you can have adverse side effects that take away your sense of taste. She was always trying to live her best life, even if that best life meant being on the sofa with a blanket. There wasn't a lot more she could do than just get by, and we only ended up having 2 years with her. I set Life Kitchen up on a Tuesday, and it feels weird that I remember that, but I tweeted this little idea. I said, I want to do one cookery class for people living with cancer. Kimberly and I, who's my best friend, the CEO of Life Kitchen, but most importantly, a girl who lost her mother to cancer. And we sat down together and said, how do we do this? And we came across a guy called Professor Barry Smith, founder of the Centre for the Study of the Senses at the University of London. As sensory scientists, when you've got problems with your senses, it seemed like the right decision. Life Kitchen works because it's barely about cancer at all. A guy called Mike Richards, 75, came into the class and he said to me, don't want to be here, son, very northern. And he said, I'm here because my wife has given up on cooking for me, and she says this might help. And he'd had, you know, quite a lot of cancer for quite a long time, and I think it had become really depressing for him. And we started the cookery class with pineapple tacos. It's really simple. It's about 6 or 7 ingredients, 5 minutes. And he just tasted it, and he just started crying. This older northern guy, 75, started crying. And I said, that is what Life Kitchen is about. You come to somewhere new and you get something exciting, you get a Life Kitchen recipe, and suddenly you've got that chance to enjoy food again. To write this book, we took it on a thing called the Refine the Recipe Tour with the Maggie's Cancer Centres. And we had 100 guests do that, and that's 100 people telling you whether your cooking is good or bad. There were a few new, quite interesting takes, but I wanted to make food that was comfortable and beautiful and flavour-packed. Cancer is individual to every family, and something like dealing with it, there is no guide. There's no guide to dealing with it, there's no guide to living with it, there's no guide to dealing with the after effects of it. But all you can do is, I think, try to spend the most time you can with people and just fulfill and live your life. Eat some good food, it always helps. And just really be there for each other.